Hi students, today we are discussing about a new chapter, Semiconductor Electronics. This chapter has high weightage in the board examinations or also in competitive examinations. So concentrate more on this chapter. So first of all, we would like to know about what is electronics. Electronics is a branch of physics which deals with the conduction of electricity through vacuum or gas or semiconductor. Okay, what is electronics? It is a branch of physics which deals with conduction of electricity through vacuum or gas or semiconductors. Okay, so our lesson name was semiconductor electronics. So we are discussing only about semiconductors. Okay, before that, we know about conductors. Conductor contains free electrons and they conduct the electricity through it. Okay, so let us take one conductor here. Best example of a conductor is metals, na? Take any metal. Okay, if you want to send certain amount of current through it, conductor allows this current. If you want to send the current in this direction, then also it allows. So current conduction through the conductors is bidirectional. You may send in this direction or in this direction. Okay. Now, in case of insulators, how the current conduction is there? We know. Insulators does not contain any free electrons, na? So whenever insulators does not contain any free electrons, they does not allow current through it. That means if you want to send current through insulator, it does not allow. Even if you want to come in this direction, it does not allow. Clear? But see, what happens in semiconductors? So, in case of semiconductor, so let us take this is one semiconductor. Depending on the arrangement of the semiconductor in the circuit, it allows current in one direction only. So, if suppose this semiconductor allows current in one direction, if you want to send the current in opposite direction, it blocks this current. If suppose it allows the current in this direction, then if you want to send the current in opposite direction, it blocks. So what happens? The major difference between the semiconductors and conductors is conductors conduct current by two directions, in both directions. But in semiconductors, current conduction is only in one direction, called as unidirection. Okay, why the semiconductors are send the current in one direction only? This is explains later in the chapter. And this special behavior of conduction of electricity through the unidirection brought many changes in the field of the electronics. Okay, in 1948, scientists invented transistor. Okay, transistor is used as on or off switches and they are also used as radio receivers, and they are also used as record players. Okay, up to 2010 or 2012 or like up to that, we are using the televisions now. So televisions are monitors in the computers. They are big in size and we are using CRT tubes in that one. Cathode ray tube. If you see the cross section view of TV, I think the TV will be appears like this. Cross sectional view. Okay, very huge in size now. But decent development of electronics, given that now these CRT tubes are replaced by LCDs and LEDs now. Liquid crystal display or light emitting diodes. Now we are using the televisions which are very thin in size. Okay, and mostly we are using the LED TVs and LED monitors now. Understand? So day by day the electronics is developed because of developing in the semiconductor electronics. Okay. On the basis of electrical properties, solids are divided into three categories. One is conductors, another one insulators, another one semiconductors. Okay, the semiconductor electrical properties are lies in between the conductors and insulators. Okay, why are using the semiconductors? Because semiconductors are small in size and they consume less power and having high durability. So they have large lifetime. That's why we are generally prefer the semiconductors than the conductors. Okay, these semiconductors are classified as elemental semiconductors and compound semiconductors. Okay, compound semiconductor again divided into inorganic semiconductors organic semiconductors and organic polymers. Understand now? Now the examples of elemental semiconductor are silicon or germanium. The entire chapter we are discussing only about the elemental semiconductors. Okay, compound semiconductors. The examples for inorganic semiconductor are cadmium sulfide, indium phosphide, and gallium arsenide. The examples for organic semiconductors are anthracene and pentacene. And examples for organic polymers are polyaniline and polythiophene, etc. Okay, the recent developments in the semiconductor electronics is mainly due to the organic semiconductors and organic polymers. Okay, so ourselves we are restricting our lesson to study about only elemental semiconductors. Okay, for this, first of all, we would like to know about what is the band theory, how the conductors, semiconductors and insulators are classified according to the band theory. Okay, let us discuss that one. So let us see about the band theory of the solids. In order to understand this theory, consider one isolated atom. Isolated means it is not influenced by the any other atom. Okay, so every atom contains some energy levels. Now we know according to the chemistry, this is 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3d. Otherwise, we are discussed in the physics as K, L, M, N shells. Okay. Electrons are present in the atom in any one of these energy states. Okay. So, how much of energy is there for electron is completely based on which energy state the electron is present. Okay. Now, this type of atoms are come close together to form a crystal. So, in crystal, what happens? Crystal is nothing but a regular periodic arrangement of atoms. So, whenever the atoms are come close together, the outer orbitals, these are called outer orbitals or outer energy levels. So, these outer energy levels are one atom combined with the neighboring atom. Okay. So, the outer energy levels of one atom overlap with the another atom. Then, the electron motion in this crystal is completely different from the isolated atom. Understand? How these energy levels are present in elementary semiconductors called germanium or silicon. Na? So, in germanium or silicon crystal, how these energy levels are arranged. Okay, let us discuss about this one. For that, I am considering crystal contains n number of atoms. Silicon or germanium crystal contains n number of atoms. Okay, so first of all, I would like to know about silicon. We know, what is the atomic number of the silicon? Silicon atomic number is 14, na? And whose electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2, na? Yes, total 14 coming. So, silicon electronic configuration is like this. And what is the atomic number of germanium? Germanium atomic number is 32. And if you write the electronic configuration, we got at ending 4s2, 4p2. Okay. So, out of this, these innermost orbits or innermost energy levels are completely filled, na? So that they didn't change in the crystal. So, in the crystal, lower energy states, for example, here consider 3s2, 3p2, na? So, until that, 1s, 2s, 2p. Okay, the electrons present in these energy levels are do not participate in the conduction. Okay, so these are unchanged. 1s, 2s, 2p means the lower energy levels are unchanged. Why? Because all the lower energy levels are completely filled with electrons and they are tightly bounded with the atoms, nucleus of the atoms. That's why they are unchanged. So, see here. In silicon, we have 4 valence electrons. germanium also we have four valence electrons na, two s electrons and two p electrons na, but the maximum number of electrons possibilities in s orbital maximum number is 2, in p orbital we have 6 now, total 8 is the maximum number of electrons are possible. Okay, please concentrate properly. Here the lower orbits are completely filled and the electrons in these orbits are tightly bounded with nucleus of the atom, so they are unchanged. Okay, the changes occurs only in the outer orbits. So in outer orbit of silicon we have the 4 electrons, outer orbit of germanium also has 4 electrons now, so we have 4 valence electrons in each atom. How many number of atoms we take in crystal? We take n atoms in the crystal now. So total 4n number of valence electrons in crystal. Okay. So the maximum number of electrons possibility is 8. So we have 8n energy levels available. How many number of available? We have 8n number of energy levels are available. So out of 8n energy levels, these 4n valency electrons are present. Okay. Now, depending on the interatomic distance between the atoms, these 8n energy levels forms a continuous band. Like this. Depending on interatomic distance between the atoms, all these 8n energy levels forms a continuous band. Okay. Now, this outermost orbitals is there now. These are formed as only one band. Band. What is a band? Band means a group of closely arranged energy levels. A group of closely arranged energy levels is called as a band. Understand? If the interatomic distance is much less, then these 8n energy levels now splits into two groups. Understand? If the interatomic distance is very less, then all these 8n energy states now splits into the two groups. Okay, this is called as lower band, named as valency band, and this is called as upper band, named as conduction band. This band name is valency band and this band name is conduction band. Okay, and the gap between the lower band of CB and upper level of the VB is called as energy level. Okay, the gap between the lower part of the conduction band and upper level of the valency band is called as forbidden energy gap. Energy gap. Okay, denoted by EG. Understand? Now, sir, how many number of energy levels are present in the valency band? Please keep in mind, it is very, very important. The significant point is the number of energy levels in the valency band depending on number of valency electrons. Number of energy levels in the valency band completely depending on number of valency electrons. So here how many number of valence electrons available in germanium or silicon crystal? 4n. So as many as 4n states are available. Maximum 4n states are available in the conduction band. So out of 8n, 4n is over now. So remaining 4n will be present in the conduction band. Clear? It is only the maximum number, not the exact number. So the number of energy states completely depending on the interatomic distance between the atoms in a crystal. Clear? So one more time, please try to understand. Isolated atom, discrete energy levels is there, but in a crystal, due to the combination number of atoms, lower energy states are unchanged. Only valency shells or valency orbitals only changes. Okay, due to the interaction of atoms with neighboring atoms. So in silicon and germanium we have 4 valence electrons now. So in germanium and silicon total number of atoms are n. So total 4n valence electrons are present in the crystal and available number of energy levels is 8n. 4n valence electrons present in 8n energy levels. Is it clear? Due to this, these 8n energy levels, based on the interatomic distance, they form a continuous band, or the band is splits into two parts. The maximum number of energy levels in the valency band is depending on valency electrons available in the crystal. Here 4n number of electrons available. So maximum number of energy states in valency band is 4n. The remaining are present for conduction band. Clear? So until now we discussed about these things. One is energy band. Energy band nothing but a group of closely spaced energy levels is called as energy band. So this is energy band. It is also one of the energy band. So we said two types of bands is there. One is valency band, another one is conduction band. In valency band, which occupied by the valence electrons. So here valence electrons is available. In each state at 0 Kelvin, there are 2 electrons are occupied by the each state at 0 Kelvin. Understand? And we said valence band contains the 4n energy states. Conduction band also contains 4n energy states at 0 Kelvin. Okay, and we also indicate that the gap between upper level of the valency band and lower level of the conduction band is called forbidden energy gap. Denoted by EC. Okay, and conduction band. The conduction band which is occupied by only free electrons. Please keep in mind, these valency electrons present in the valency band are not conduct any electricity. Only the electrons which are present in the conduction band only conduct electricity. At 0 Kelvin, all the electrons are present only in the valency band. No electrons present in the conduction band. Okay, it is completely empty. It is completely filled at 0 Kelvin only. Except 0 Kelvin means at any room temperature, maybe some electrons are present in the conduction band. If number of free electrons availability in the conduction band is increases, it conducts more amount of current through it. If we have more number of valence electrons now, they do not use it for conduction of electricity. Understand? Now, basing on this band theory, now we are discussing about how these valency band and conduction band are present in conductors, insulators and semiconductors. Okay. So let us see in the insulators. In the insulators, the valency band and conduction band are separated by energy gap whose value is greater than the 3 electron volt. Okay, the energy gap value is how much? 3 electron volts. So whenever the energy gap is more, maximum number of the valence electrons are present in the conduction band only, and these are tightly bounded with the nucleus of the atom. Okay, these are tightly bounded with the nucleus of atom and conduction band is empty. Conduction band empty and valence band contains the valence electrons which are tightly bounded with the nucleus of the atom. That's why insulators does not conduct any electricity, because conduction band is empty. Now if you raise the temperature, if you increase the temperature, even though the gap is very huge, that's why these electrons are not possible to jump to the conduction band. Understand? So always the insulators does not allow any current through it. But while in case of conductors, see, conduction band and valency band are overlap with each other now, so that energy gap value is 0 electron volt. So some valency bands and conduction bands are combined together. That's why the electrons which are present here free to move now. Whenever they are free to move, they conduct electricity through it. Okay. Now, particularly we discuss about semiconductors. Now, please keep in mind, in semiconductors, the valency band and conduction bands are separated by energy gap whose value is less than 3 electron volt. Here more than 3 electron volt, here less than 3 electron volt. For example, if you take germanium, one of the semiconductors, whose energy gap value is 0.7 electron volt, and for silicon 1.1 electron volt. Okay, they are very less compared with 3 electron volts now. So what happens? At 0 Kelvin, absolute zero temperature, valency electrons are present in the valency band. Okay, conduction band is completely empty. So conduction band completely empty means at 0 Kelvin a semiconductor behaves like a insulator. At 0 Kelvin or at absolute zero temperature, semiconductors behaves like insulators. Okay, at room temperature, the electrons which are present in the valency band gains the energy and the gap is less now. That's why these electrons are jumps to the conduction band. Whenever the electrons present in the conduction band, then these are behaves like a free electrons now. So they conduct the electricity. So at room temperature, semiconductors conducts electricity. At 0 Kelvin or at absolute zero temperature, semiconductor behaves like a insulator. So initially we said semiconductor has the properties which are lies in between the insulators and conductors now. So at 0 Kelvin, semiconductor behaves like an insulator. At room temperature, it behaves like a conductor. Understand? So how much of current passes through it completely depending on how many number of free electrons present in the conduction band only. The number of valency band, the number of electrons in the valency band does not conduct any electricity. Please keep this point. Okay. See the differences between the conductors, insulators and semiconductors. In conductors, valency band and conduction band are overlap. insulators, they are largely separated. In semiconductors, they are separated by small distance. Na? Use forbidden energy gap. Zero here. Greater than 3 electron volt. Less than 3 electron volt, we said. Na? And at room temperature, its conductivity is very high. Conductors have more conductivity. Insulators, zero. Semiconductors, the conductivity is lies between conductors and insulators. Okay. Examples are metals, rubber, glass, mica, and for this one, germanium, silicon. And finally, the most important thing was, conductors have low resistivity value. Value is 10 power minus to 10 power minus 8 ohm meter. If they ask conductivity, we know the reciprocal of resistivity is known as the conductivity now. So reverse this value, you got the conductivity values. And they have high resistivity, 10 power 11 to 10 power 19. And again, the resistivity of semiconductors is lies in between the conductors and insulators. And the value is 10 power minus 5 to 10 power 6 ohm meter. Clear? Please note it down. Tomorrow, we are discussing about different types of semiconductors. Okay? Thank you.